Hello, and welcome to the multiplexer series on basics of multiplexers and signal switches. This video series explains the basics of analog signal switches offered by Texas Instruments. In this video, we will have a short discussion on timing characteristics of switches and multiplexers, such as turn-on time, turn-off time, break before make delay, and transition time. The goal of this video is to understand the timing characteristics of switches and where to find these characteristics in the datasheet. Let's start with T-on. This characteristic may also be called T-switch or T-enable in different datasheets. T-on is the time required for the switch path to be charged to the on state. For this example switch, the T-on time for VIO A and B are measured from the time the select line reaches the logic low or high threshold to the time VIO A or B reaches 90% of its expected high state voltage. Similarly, T-off is the time required for the switch path to be charged to the off state. T-off is measured from the time the select line reaches the logic low or high threshold to the time the VIO reaches 10% of its high state voltage. These timing characteristics determine how fast you can switch to different inputs, which is important for applications which need to cycle through inputs quickly, such as sample and hold applications and protection systems. Break before make delay is a safety feature that prevents two inputs from connecting when the device is switching. The output first breaks from the on state switch before making the connection with the next on state switch. The time delay between the break and the make is known as break before make delay, or TBBM. In this circuit, TBBM is measured from the time VIO drops to 90% of its on-state value until the time that it rises again to 90% of its on-state value. Without break before make, you could see unwanted glitches in your output. Transition time, T-transition, or sometimes T-tran, is defined as the time taken by the output of the device to rise or fall 10%, after the select signal has risen or fallen past the logic threshold. The 10% transition measurement is utilized to provide the timing of the device. System level timing can then account for the time constant added from the load resistance and load capacitance. Please note that most devices are measured at the 10% and 90% points, but some devices may have been measured to the 50% point. These timing characteristics can often be found in the electrical characteristics section or timing requirements section of the datasheet. These characteristics are specified under certain test conditions, as listed in the datasheet. These conditions may include load resistance and capacitance, as well as differing supply voltage and signal voltage. Some datasheets may even include figures showing the measurement setup for each timing characteristic, located in the parameter measurement information section or detailed description section of the datasheet. In addition, the typical characteristics section of the datasheet may show curves of certain timing characteristics as a function of supply voltage or temperature. Thank you for watching the timing characteristics video of the TI Precision Labs Multiplexers Basics series. To find more multiplexers and signal switches, technical resources, and search products, visit ti.com.